السلام عليكم، how are you شباب؟ Now we continue for explaining the temperature state temperature definition and equation formula. Before going to the next slide, here in the phase change, there is another change for the phase between the gas to immediately the solid or from solid to the gas. This process we call it as a change from solid to gas sublimation. And from gas to the solid sedimentation. عملية التسامي وعملية الترسيب. Now, as we mentioned before, heat is a form of energy, which is energy supply increases, the vibration of molecules will increase, and which turn on the temperature also increased. Now there is another parameter. We call it sometimes heat units, British thermal units. What's the definition? It is amount of heat required to increase 1 pound of pure water by 1 degree Fahrenheit at 68 degree Fahrenheit in atmospheric pressure. What's the meaning here? How much heat required to increase 1 pound of pure water? There is no salt, no minerals, only water, pure. But there is a conditions for this water. What are these conditions? The condition, this water should be at 68 degree Fahrenheit and it should be under atmospheric pressure, normally at the sea level. These two conditions should be 68 degree Fahrenheit and it should be at atmospheric pressure. Now the amount of heat required to increase 1 pound, for example, to increase the water from 68 degree Fahrenheit to 69 degree Fahrenheit, how much required amount of energy, of heating energy, to raise this degree? This one we call it British thermal unit, BTU. Type example. If BTU is the unit used for a capacity of air conditioning, 1 ton of refrigeration, which is around 12,000 BTUs, mean that AC can remove 12,000 BTU per hour as measured for pure water. Okay. The same thing, calories. It is the similar meaning for BTU, but in SI system. This one in English, the British thermal units, and this one in SI units. Also the same definitions. How much amount of heat required to increase 1 gram instead of 1 pound here? I will say here 1 gram of pure water by 1 degree. At 4 degrees Celsius and atmospheric pressure. So the conditions here, the water should be 4 degrees and it should be under atmospheric pressure, also pure water. There is no minerals, no salts, nothing inside the water dissolved. So the required amount of heat in order to increase 1 gram of this pure water by 1 degree under these two conditions, 4 degree and atmospheric pressure, this one we call it calories. It is heat energy amounts. The same thing. Now, the BTU or calorie needed to increase 1 unit of weight by 1 degree is called a specific heat. The amount of BTU or calories needed in order to 1 unit of weight, not mass, but reality it's mentioned as mass. It in reality is mass, not weight. By 1 degree called specific heat. Right. It's the heat energy required to increase the temperature of 1 unit of weight. It's really not weight, it is mass. Of any material by 1 degree at a specific pressure and temperature. We call it specific heat. Each material has its own constant specific heat. Table 8.1, which shown in the page number 122. A specific heat of some uncommon material, for example, gold, 0.0316 specific heat. The unit it is what here? Either BTU per pound Fahrenheit or calories per gram Fahrenheit. For quarters, as example, if I say 0.188 BTU pound per Fahrenheit or calories per gram Fahrenheit Celsius, it means that we need supply 1.188 BTU in order to increase 1 pound of quartz by 1 Fahrenheit, or we need 0.11 calories in order to increase 1 gram of quartz by 1 degree Celsius. This is the meaning of specific heat. It is a property of materials, like we mentioned that a specific weight, similar to weight. There is a mistake here. He mentioned weight. It should be mass, not weight. Now, in order to calculate the heat rate, we can use the following formula. Q, heat amount, mass of material, multiply specific heat of material, properties of material, difference in the temperature, final and initial. Example. What is the heat required to raise the temperature of 1.5 kilogram mass 120 degrees Celsius if the specific heat of the mass is 0.37 calorie gram per gram and degree Celsius? He need to know how much heat in order to raise it. طيب. Now, in the question, he say how much. Okay, can see it in. What is the heat required to raise the temperature of 1.5 kilogram mass, 120 degrees Celsius? That means amount of raised temperature is 120 degrees Celsius. That means the difference between the existing and existing temperature and the new one is 120 degrees Celsius. Okay, the mass for this material is 1.5 kilogram. So we need to raise the temperature for this 1.5 kilogram mass around 120 degrees Celsius more. And the properties of this mass material is 0.37 calories per gram per degree Celsius. So that means it needs 0.37 calories in order to raise it 1 gram for 1 degree. So it needs a heat amount which is equal as per this function. Mass multiply specific heat multiply the difference in the temperature. Just here 1.5 is the mass, and we will change it to gram because here our specific weight is specific heat is given per gram and per degree Celsius. So we'll multiply all of them, it gives me 66,600 calories. If it is in British or BTU, British thermal units or BTU, it is the same 0.37, but here the degree Celsius it will be different, and also the value for here about will be different, of course. Okay, now return back to our slide. We'll go here to the method of transferring the heat. Three methods of transferring the heat: conduction, convection, radiation. Conduction. That means the heat will transfer from one molecule of material to the next, from the same rod or from the same material. The same material, the same body, will conduct the heat temperature from one edge to another edge. as example rod, and you will heat the head of this rod, and this heating will transfer from the head of this rod until to reach the end, the other end, the other edge of this rod. So the heat here by conducting will transfer from one molecular to another, from molecular to another, and so on. So depending on the thermal conductivity of the material, the time of conduction is changing. Now, so of course the time difference, for example heating the steel is different than copper, and so on, and also the same thing for the aluminium. Right, let's go to the convection. Convection, it's transferring the heat through the motion of fluid that have conthermal energy. As the heated one or the heated parts molecular will have lower density than the cold molecular, so the convection, this molecular will raise up, the heated molecules will raise up and the cold one will comes down. That's why it's coming like this way. This way we call it convection through the fluids normally. Another one, radiation, is emitting of energy by electromagnetic waves that travel through the speed of light. Sun is one of the famous example for that. Right. Normally, three types of transferring the heat can't be happened one time. As example for this one, when you see this one creating a fire, the fire itself will emit radiation, and you will feel the heating coming from the fire by the radiation through electric waves. So this one by the radiation, electromagnetic waves. If you touch a certain oven or a certain container, the heat that touch the surface of this container will conduct the heating parts from one side to the edge of the handle of this oven, the normal of this container. And also, if there is a material fluid inside this container, the heated molecular will comes up and the cold one will return back to comes down. So all these conditions happen in one location. Okay, Shabab, I will stop here inshallah, and we will continue for the next video. Thank you for watching this one and waiting for me.